Okay. So, this is Pony Island. I watched the trailer for this on Steam and about 10 minutes of Ty's stream and immediately went, I need to play this game. I need to stream this game. So, I'm gonna get
Sweet.
started.
Why does that fill me with dread? That fills me with dread.
Yeah. It'll be fine.
I'm just going to adjust this volume a tiny bit.
I am like actually concerned, but I will be okay. So.
It's a very cute game.
Yeah.
Yeah, dev.
It's called Pony Island. How could it be
Wait.
anything but cute?
Dan Mullen. Why does that sound familiar? Is that what's the Super Meat Boy guy?
No, it's Ed McMullen.
Oh, Ed McMullen, got it. All right. That's why that sounded familiar. I may have never actually seen anything about this person.
Also, sorry, this is a game that doesn't start up with the volume playing, so I'm just doing on the fly volume adjustment. We should be good now. All
Okay.
right. So here's our options, anti-aliasing, advanced RNG, free ticket, cheerful facade. I'm gonna hit free ticket. Nice.
What's the binary option?
I don't know, but the game does not like me clicking that, so I'm not going to.
There's a snowman.
Turn off in-app purchases. That stuff is nonsense. You'll need that. Also, can't click the snowman.
What about obscure options?
It doesn't do anything, apparently. Right, so.
I have about a 99% certainty that none of those options did anything.
Well, I can't start the game. But there's an option to fix start menu. Okay. Just put that back up there. All right.
Well,
this game appears to be broken, like actually.
So this was part of the stuff that I saw that I'm actually intensely interested in, because the part I saw of ties actually had like if you have an understanding of programming, you can do the puzzles better.
Okay.
I'm not really sure about that.
Anywho.
Like, I'll make the judgment call on that one eventually, but so far it seems like it's a game about clicking and tracking.
It said this game was made in 1992. I highly doubt that.
I don't know. That's what TVs look like in 1992. I could understand.
All right, so like this one seems to be sending the thing back to the start, and you just take that out and you put the arrow in, and there you go.
Got it.
Yeah, I fixed the loading bar. Uh-oh.
When are we getting to the ponies?
No, the game itself is apparently actually fun, but it takes a while to load because it was made in 1992.
Oh, got it.
The game's talking to us. I guess the game is starting up.
Yeah, that's like when you get into a Hearthstone match and it just tells you all the different kinds of players you'll fight.
All right, so this is the game. It's sort of like an auto runner, and you just keep going, and you left click to jump.
All right.
Also,
Yeah.
you can do funny stuff with the head. Make the head go all the way around.
Why does it look like a
Guessing if you
posthumous photo?
So, funny story about this. My stream normally like glitches out and fractures and shit like that just because of like my connection being awful. So that just makes this game look like almost normal. I'm not seeing most of the glitches that you all are.
Nice.
Congratulations on your level up.
Yeah, I got a
Insane.
ton of
It's gonna,
levels.
yeah, it's gonna restore your stamina, and you can now take on higher level dungeons now.
Sweet. Yeah.
I'm gonna get
No,
some
they didn't
flourish
have
jumps in.
they didn't have freemium games in
Oh
92.
man, look at those sweet jumps.
Sweet
This is
jumps.
high level play here. Oh, I almost missed that one.
Hey, so why aren't there any colors in this?
It was 1992. Color wasn't invented then.
It's got blue. Like this.
Alright.
Yeah, you know, those 3-bit color plant. 3-bit color palettes.
Actually, wait, hold up. I gotta make sure. Okay, capture mouse cursor is on. Good. Alright.
Also, that pony looks incredibly sad. Or distressed.
Oh, wait. Actually. Yeah, okay. Anyway, I was just gonna say, I love the one here that just says, dude, stop.
Alright. Wow.
What?
This is. Okay.
Yeah. Before you say, I think I understand this game, no, you don't.
No, I was never going to say that. It's just...
Good.
Okay.
So, I got a ticket. My level is now in overflow error.
Oh, good.
Oh, good.
I think I need to keep this from actually finishing, and then...
Look at that real-ass hand showing up in front of the TV.
Oh, okay. So if we want to experience the rest of the game, we have to insert our soul.
Hmm.
You can do that. We'll just watch.
Yeah. I'm keeping mine.
Collection.
Might need it for a
paywall,
rainy day.
Null soul, check soul, validate soul, soul required.
Ooh.
Do not proceed. Well, I've never been one to listen.
Yeah. Who reads these things, anyways?
Whoops. I did a thing.
Also, of note, there are 2 exclamation points around the word not. The problem is that the word not doesn't actually do anything in most programming languages, so, like, the 4 total exclamation points just cancels it out twice. So you should do proceed, in fact.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
No, oh, I found the desktop.
Sweet.
There's a couple broken files in here. Oh, there's a help.txt. Oh, that doesn't help at all.
Ah, yes, computers in 1992.
I have been trapped in this game for what feels like an eternity. Endless playing.
The funny thing is, this doesn't actually look like computers in 1992.
All right, found another game.
What are you talking about? This looks exactly what computers looked like in 1992. I was there.
Were you?
Technically.
Ah, fair enough.
I may have been one, but, like, whatever.
Now you got a space shooter.
Nice.
Yay!
1992, let's see. I had a computer that was running on the good old... How big were
I
they?
I was playing Number Cruncher.
Yeah, Number Cruncher on like 8.5-inch floppies.
God.
I had a ColecoVision Atom,
oh,
I think, in 92. Now, ColecoVision Atom ran on cassette tapes.
All right.
You having a good time there, Crumb?
There's so many.
Yeah. How are you supposed to win?
Oh, no.
Welcome to
I see.
Galaxy.
T-I-C... K T wait, how do you spell?
T I C K E T. That's ticket.
Ah, there we go. Nice. Oh, I have a message. 14 messages. Hello.
Well then.
It's me. Newbie. Hello, it's me, newbie.
Are you a boy or a girl?
Oh, I have another message. Uh-oh.
No. Damn it!
Did I?
I think you shouldn't be talking to these people.
Yeah, the strangers online will tend to steal your soul using video games, so...
Well, this predates the World Wide Web, so this is all Usenet.
I think this is, like, an origin story for the World Wide Web.
Ah.
I think whoever made this was high.
Somebody... yes, that you are correct.
It's like one of those games that makes you just uncomfortable. That's the entire point of it.
Whoa. The other man is angry.
Who, Hopeless Soul or Lucifer?
What?
Oh, is that? Oh, that is Lucifer. Oh, okay.
Say yes, master. No.
Yeah, I grew up.
Anything I type in does yes, master.
Oh my god.
Alright. There you go.
Close it. Go play Pony Island again.
What? Oh, okay, that's not me.
Huh. There are problems here.
Are you moving the mouse?
No, I was not moving the mouse. Hello, Satan Tech. Uh-oh.
Satan Tech Incorporated.
I think the game's different.
Oh. Options. Option.
Hey, newbie.
Yeah?
How are your fiddle playing skills?
How am I what now?
Fiddle playing skills.
Oh, dear.
Have you been practicing the fiddle since you were 7?
Guys, the game's harder.
Sure it is.
Can't wait for it to load.
That pony still looks very, very depressed.
Oh, dear.
Oh, God. Oh. Oh, wow. It's more challenging.
Oh, okay, I can go in the options now. So, oh no, the snowman went away.
What is it now?
What about cheerful facade?
Facade?
Nope. That broke.
Whatever.
Everything's breaking.
What about cheer and happiness? Oh, that's the binaries.
Oh, I see. Nice.
Oh.
Security settings. Parental controls. Send error reports. Yes, no, maybe, I don't care. Can you repeat the question?
So, which one of you can read binary?
I can, but unfortunately, I have to get out of here, so I will catch you all later. Sorry about that.
All right, goodbye.
Huh.
Good luck.
Okay.
Oh, good. Okay. I know this.
Do you?
Well, MCMIC dash Z3A7X dash whatever. Newbie, I think this game is very silly. Maybe.
I'm just gonna leave these off. Old prototype options. Ah, free will.
Damn it.
Alright, I can't turn any of these on. Oh, wait. So I got pony salvation options, and as my cursor gets closer to it, a music starts playing.
Okay.
That is some weird tapestry there.
Alright. So yeah, this is my understanding, is that this game has this whole, like, weird thing to it, but there's this, the code thing that's, like, kind of the real game. It's, like, the whole hacking stuff.
Okay. Uh-huh. So you have a couple go forwards and a couple loops back.
This is the part I saw of like what I'm playing right now is what I saw of Ty's stream, and once I'm done with this I'll be in the dark a bit more. Also,
okay,
obviously on the Steam page they kind of give the whole hint that, you know, the game isn't what you think it is sort of stuff.
Oh yeah, this game is definitely not what I thought it was going to be when you said let's play Pony Island.
Yeah, that. Mm-hmm. You see, it's a misdirection.
Yes, yes, it is. You've got me there.
Ah, I see. I'm not, no.
So, pony laser is right mouse click. And,
this is like the hack beam.
Okay.
I found it. I found the game.
This is a game, all right.
So, you can destroy the skulls and anything. Can you can destroy the hurdles? No.
Nope.
Hmm.
We've reached the end.
No, now it's level two.
So with the red and blue on here, does that mean if you wear 3D goggles, it will look weird?
Oh man. If only. Maybe that's it. Maybe this is all 3D. He's put 3D goggles on. He got the whole shebang going.
Be like the Virtual Boy level of 3D.
Whoa. Game just did a jump scare. And my character was scared of it.
Oh no. Yeah, I've never been one for horror games.
Ah, okay. Azazel.exe? Yeah, sure, okay. They did a switch around on me. I like that the demon program has to type everything out too. That's really good.
All right. Try to delete the... Yeah, you gotta get rid of those things.
Oh, wow. Nice. Get on with it, Lord.
This is a thing.
Do you feel threatened, newbie, by the demons?
Maybe. Oh, you dick. I see. Alright.
So it's like if it programming finishes... checkers.
Shit. Oh god, you actually have to be pretty fast. Like, you actually have to be moving pretty quickly. Because he'll go for a spot, and if you fill it in first, then he'll actually just move to another spot.
Good old Twitch controls for programming, yep.
Oh boy.
Got him. Nice.
Well done.
All right, one more.
One more.
Oh, what? What are the black things?
They're super happy fun time things.
I have been looking at the code. Like the goat Osin.
Uh-huh.
And bring function called, and you just deliver blood to it.
Oh, the black ones lock stuff in place.
I see.
Okay, that's fine. That just means you need to have a left arrow on the bottom middle one and a down arrow on the one on the left hand side.
Yeah, okay. I freaked it. Oh, there's a reset.
You can reset on the bottom right.
Yeah. Alright.
Well, I'm glad that the demon can't reset.
Shit. Yep. Yeah. I got owned.
He's pretty quick.
Oh no, I'm stuck in a loop.
Oh no.
Alright. Definitely gotta put the resets here. Arrow over down here. That one goes in the empty space. That one goes in that lock space. This one goes here. This reset goes down here. He's gotta be quick at putting everything that he puts over in the right places and make sure you fill up the blocking spaces.
Exactly.
False prophet. Nope.
Yeah.
I open up the delete core file.exe and he closes the window. Not if I can. Got him. Oh, there we go.
All right.
Now we're in.
Newbie?
Yeah.
This is a weird game.
Is it?
Yeah.
I don't see it.
Oh, there's two more core files. Wanted this game except mods. Maybe we can find one online for a core file.
Me. Hello? Okay. I have done the deed. Oh, I've done the dead. No! Yeah, that was weird.
Oh dear.
Login my user profile. The password is 2734. I feel like I should be writing shit down. There's my notepad that I use for Bloodborne. Found it. 2734.
Okay.
Everything is corrupted. Missing. There's a missing no file.
Good thing about missing no is missing no is unintentional.
So what was that? 2734. Oops. Why does enter go to R?
They want to mess you up.
Hey. Search prog tools. Okay. So what we have to mess with sliders.
Yeah, do you want to degarble it?
I didn't even catch that that's what that said. Oh, I found something. Got him. Oh no, we have to go into Pony Island one more time.
Let's do it.
This is so dumb.
All right, so
go check out the corrupted profile next to his or her.
It's me. All right. I don't have a password though. Password. Well, that's doing something. I broke it.
Oh no.
That worked.
That's good. I'm glad you know the password.
Password backup .txt. Guess none. A hopeless soul. Corrupted was apparently I am error. And Lucifer's is ponies. Nice. Got it. All right. Settlers of Satan.
Uh-huh.
That game was around in 92.
Huh, I did it.
What did you do?
Oh, it's for a ticket.
Oh.
So how many tickets do you need?
You know, I'm not gonna do this one. Actually, what's up?
What are you do? Why are you poking the bear?
Because if you poke the bear enough, it will go to sleep.
Uh oh. What? All right, back in Pony Island. Which is now not even doing a thing. Satan Tech Incorporated, minus 666. Nice.
Oh boy. Adventure mode.
Satan's upgraded his game.
Uh oh. Well, at least we have some colors now.
I like just this game about playing Satan's really shitty game.
Wasn't that the plot of Banjo-Tooie? No. It's Klungo. That may have been another Banjo game.
No, I got this, bro.
Alright.
Oh yeah, the Klungo thing, that was in Nuts and Bolts.
Yeah, that one.
Alright, so we have these portal things that are like go-to statements.
Interesting.
All right, so we gotta get north. That's where the data is. I refuse your conventions. No. No, of course. You need money. You need money to cross the river Styx. Duh. XP Beach.
Oh god. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay. Programming. Now we're getting into the meat of it. I'm just gonna let that go for a bit. Let that scale up. Maybe probably shouldn't let it overflow, so. I don't know. I feel like that's programmed in here.
Well, what is the overflow of value? What are we looking at here? Just normal integers, or?
Well, it seems like they're ints, so I guess we'd have to get really huge.
Yeah. Well, they could just be short bytes or whatever, so 256 or 255 would be the highest you could go.
Oh. Actually got hit.
You're terrible at this.
I'm not bad at video games. No. Not true.
That's impossible.
God damn it.
You get hit again?
No. Saying god damn it at your joke. This is like an actual game now. Alright, I can get behind this.
You had to spend some time creating the game yourself before you could play it.
No, we're the bug tester. We just had to fix it a little bit. Oh. But, ponies can't swim. I see.
Hmm. It could swim if it was a seahorse. That's all I got, I'm sorry.
It's a good joke.
Do you need to program in the swimming ability into the game?
No, I have to go grind for EXP.
Ugh.
Oh, goodness.
Levels long. I'm just looking at the little cursor on the bottom and how long it's taking to move.
You'll be fine.
Yeah, every time I feel like I just jumped a bit too early for the gates.
Can't ponies fly yet?
Pegasus, duh.
Oh, okay. Well, this is a unicorn, technically.
Nice.
Unless it's cowlick on the front.
I thought it was cowlick.
Only 99 experience to go.
Gotta be a faster way.
It's gotta be a better... Oh, look. I got this.
That's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, there's a game made by Double Fine called Hack and Slash, which is a lot like this.
Uh-huh. I should pick that up sometime. That game looked really cool.
It's like a sort of Legend of Zelda adventure type game, but if you get to a thing you can't pass, you just, you know, modify the code. The thing about Double Fine is they do all these games that are really cool for a while, and then they just stop them, so.
The other thing with Double Fine is they're generally too ambitious. Like, Tim Schafer just tries to throw too much shit into his games.
Yeah. There you go. You can fly now.
I want the ticket. But no, Hack and Slash looked really cool, and it gets, like, really complex later in the, oh, jeez. In the original, quick look for it, they show it off later on where it's like, it starts out with you, like, hacking, the values of monsters and changing them so you can do stuff like, every time I hit this rock, it gives me a heart, or I hack this enemy to shoot hearts instead of fire, or I make this enemy fight on my side, like, weird stuff like that.
Yeah.
But later on in the game, like, you're going into dungeons that are, like, programs?
So you need to be able to read code and,
yeah.
Program it yourself.
Like, you go into these parts, and by changing part of the code, it actually changes the layout of the dungeon.
That's kind of cool. Why bother going to get a small key if you could just erase that door?
Exactly.
I'm wondering by the end of this that the game is just going to be so well made. Well, actually hard rather than what it is right now in quote-unquote adventure mode.
Got it. Oh, God damn it.
Matter.
I landed on a thing.
Oh, you landed on a pole.
Yeah.
Start again.
Like, actually trying to remember which... Like, I have to process in my head, like, okay, this is... Like, I'm floating because I'm holding down this click, so I have to use this click in order to stop floating, and then this one to jump, and it's actually kind of messing with me a little bit.
Well, yeah, you're doing everything on a normal mouse, right? Or do you have one of those fancy mice?
It's a normal mouse.
Mice.
So, usually... ponies have, you know, feathery wings and not bat wings.
Game's not perfect.
No? No, it's not? Okay.
Yeah, bark, 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 bark.
It looks like a coin that you just picked up.
How do I get the ticket?
Did you find the secret exit?
I refuse.
In Super Mario World, there's a secret exit that usually brings you along the way, so... You have to go grab a key and put in the keyhole or something.
It's haunting you, isn't it?
Hold up. This is actually confusing as shit.
Okay. Alright, so you're looking, trying to get the variable under a zero.
I think I got it. Nice. Also, there was another hacking thing in there. I fucked up. That was probably what got me to the ticket. No. All right, I'm gonna go see what's up with Charm. I feel like that's the actual way I want to go. Whoa, what? I'm a knight now.
Sweet. Like a chess knight?
Like no. Like a crusader knight.
Oh, nice. Hey, you're playing a paladin again.
Yes, good. Everything is as it should be.
It's your default.
Feels right.
Does a paladin grow bat wings when it flies?
Oh, but I'm a pony again when I went to a level.
Oh, okay.
I didn't think that the execution of this game was actually going to get a little, like, challenging for me. But, like, actually, like, I don't know, just the two clicks is fucking with me a bit.
If it has been, like, Kickstarter funded?
I think this was a game jam.
Oh, that makes sense. I couldn't see anyone investing in this game.
I mean, this is a thing. I'll give them that.
Alright. Let's see what's going on here. Oh, so, there it is. People, yeah, somebody points out that people invested in Frog Fractions 2.
That is true. Frog Fractions 1, though, was so weird that people were probably investing in Frog Fractions 2 to be like, what can they do further? Did that come out?
You know the whole deal with Frog Fractions 2, right?
No, I don't.
Okay, so it's a Kickstarter, but it has the stipulation of the game will come out and everything. Like, he will release the game. Yeah. I actually don't know who made Frog Fractions. But the creator will never say if the game was Frog Fractions or not. It will not come out as Frog Fractions 2. And the creator will never admit if the game is Frog Fractions or not.
So the Kickstarter rewards were like nothing?
I don't remember.
Give me $40 and nothing.
This part is going for a bit.
Yeah. It's odd because you're walking through the Desert of Sin.
Well, it's odd because the game has been so good up to this point in constantly, like,
engaging, yeah, and telling
you
what to
do. Yeah, and then this has just been kind of the same thing for the last 20 minutes.
Yep.
There we go.
I found the Cave of Visions. Show me a vision. A glimpse. Oh, what the? Three questions. Who was I? When did I die? Who killed me?
Whoa.
Which one should I ask?
I think, who was I?
Who was I? Your name was Theodore. You left behind a mother and a daughter.
Alright.
Did I die?
No, I only get one.
Oh.
Oh.
Alright, now start again from the very beginning of this game. We can ask the other two.
Nah. I don't know if I could, like. I doubt I could ever actually play this game multiple times.
Yeah.
Like, it's definitely an experience. I'm having fun the first time. Like, this is weird, and I love it. But it's definitely a one-time only game.
Well, the thing about Game Jam games, if this
nice.
Is in fact one,
that,
is that...
That pro move.
They don't need to be played more than a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
Back when I was working with the Adventure Game Studio program, I would hold little competitions to make hour games. Games you can make in an hour. They were never any good, but you got it start to finish in an hour.
Alright, time to, you know, apparently it's time to take a break.
Alright.
Break.
No, I do not quit. Oh, there we go. Yep, found it. Alright.
Alright.
Alright, I think I got it. So we do this jump, which will... do that, which will set that back to the beginning, so then we do this. No, it should go down one more step. Alright, so now Y is positive. X is positive, Y is negative, now Y is going to increase. Alright, yes, yes, good. Oh! Oh dang. Okay, I didn't see that one. Misread that, but that is also easily fixed. Wait. Alright. Got it. Good.
You must be a programmer in real life.
Maybe. I possibly have a degree in computer engineering. Alright. What was the point of that? Oh, okay. It was to allow you to stay in the game. Got it. Then we enter Satan's house. Oh no, Satan's getting saucy, and we're not taking a break. Content build. I hope it's good. It's gonna work. more friendly guy. Oh, I found the total screen. Alright. Set data to 0. Data plus 25. We need data over 100. This is pretty simple too, actually. So we hit that loop there, we take these out, we leave that there, we put a portal there, and we put a portal there.
Now those portals are just go-to signals, aren't they?
Yeah, they're go-to, but it's like, it's a go-to in the fact that like you enter one, you can exit the other.
Okay.
So yeah, they're just go-tos, that's all they are.
Yeah, but those are bad. Especially for multi-threading.
I mean, if you want to get technical in a bunch of like computer terminology outside the realm of this game, yeah, go-tos are bad.
But yes, in 92, maybe not so much. That's what I liked about those old look around you things. Those fake science shows that they made in Britain. You remember those, right, Newbie?
Oh, is that the one with like... I think I remember those. Those were like the boiling an egg thing that was from that.
Yes. But the beginning of it was they just put 10 print look around you, 20 go to 10. And that was the program they made. And I'm just like, that just infuriates me because that program will need to be, you know, broken in order to get out of it.
It seems easy. Okay. Oh, Jesus. Okay. No, this is not easy. All right. So we got A over... Okay. Alright, so put this here. This here. This one over here, and then this here will allow us to overflow B.
This is amazing.
I'm loving this. This part is fucking great for me.
Well,
as soon as you get really... B data over that, you can just move the purple one on the bottom middle up to the top right.
Yep. Then we get.
I get it.
And C overflowed. And then the final part of all of it is just shuffling around the left arrow until you hit the C. The C is over. Whoa! That was almost bad. It's not. No! Don't lose my game. No, it's not good. Everything's upside down. Oh, it's not in place. No. I freaked it. Don't lose my game.
Man, this devil is trying its best to program a nice game for you.
Oh, wait, now I can go get the ticket.
You and your tickets.
No, it's gone. Damn it.
Oh, well.
See, the thing you don't know is the tickets are Tebow's.
Of course they are.
Okay.
If I remember right, the soul said that we need to keep going north, but that's now south, so... Oh, that's also the edge of the map. Alright, then we just go to Satan. Satan House.
Did you write down all the information about you being Theodore?
Yeah, I was Theodore. You had a mother and a daughter?
I think it was a wife and a daughter.
Oh. Hello, Boer.
It did say mother and daughter.
Oh, mother and daughter.
Weird.exe. Oh, that's fun.
Your name is Elmer J. Fudd, millionaire. You want a mansion and a yacht?
All right, nice, hang on, I'll take it. All right, it's time for Satan fight.
Time for something, all right.
It's the end of the game, final level of adventure mode.
Sweet. Then does it become a dating sim after this?
Nice.
If only.
Oh no, the final boss is Satan.
Who'd have thunk it?
Beelzebub. Oh jeez.
Yeah, that's different.
Alright, I see what's going on here. This is actually very different.
Interesting.
Yeah, I was expecting more programming stuff. Not like, fuck balls. Okay. This is actually a little hard here.
I think this is pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, it's like, I was not expecting an actual... It's actually, like, there's a lot going on.
Got this, newbie. I moderately believe in you.
I think I want... Oh, I gotta shoot the chin, too. Ah, fucking hell. Okay, so the problem is, I don't know if you've been able to notice this, but your beam has a limited amount of time it can go.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck me. Alright. Sorry, this is actually a little hard.
But you're enjoying it.
Yeah, this is actually... Yeah. This is alright. This is pretty alright. Alright, I just got the last spot to go. We gotta keep making... Oh, that was a dick move, actually. I had to jump to avoid, but he spawned spikes above me.
Womp womp.
Is that playing fair?
Yes, insane. How dare he?
This is Beelzebub. Which is weird that it's not, like, fly themed.
I'm pretty sure that's another name for Satan.
No, Beelzebub is the Lord of Flies. Actually, shooting the chin, a number one strategy, because he can't spawn spikes anymore.
You are messing him up.
I did it. What? Get fucking...
It is both, actually.
I am okay with that.
I did it.
Hooray!
Wait. Uh-oh.
That gas in the room? Oh no.
Yeah, it's outside of the monitor. Oh well.
Oh, this was like in an arcade, okay. Alright, I'm gonna split the video right here.
Okay.